Sorry, I guess there was some problem with the audio, so I was not able to hear you properly. Okay, so let us not waste any more time and we should start with the session. Okay. Okay, so by the time I guess everyone is now very much aware of the thing that how you should interact, because we were having some issues with the things. So you should use either a mic, or you should always use a headset, or you should dial the conference number, okay, for the clarity. But always try that you are muted by yourself, and also I will try to mute you, because we don't want any unwanted disturbance in the classes. Okay, then whenever you want to chat with me, or you have some questions regarding the topics, unmute yourself. It's not a problem. What you can do is you can chat with me on the chat box if there are some questions. Okay. And also, I would request everyone that make this session interactive. Just don't be like listening only to the session. Okay. Make the session interactive with me. Whatever questions I'm asking you, please respond it back. Okay. So for today, our agenda will be going through some of the things like SDLC, that is software development lifecycle, then software testing lifecycle. What is QA testing? Why in today's world and in the market, why QA testing is important? Why you should take it as a career? Okay, and what all things we would be covering in Bhagya? What would be our curriculum and the batch schedule? Okay, so firstly about me, I am Vidya. I would be taking your classes for QA, and I have 10 years of IT experience, and apart from that I have 3 years of experience in the teaching field of QA. Okay, now before going to other things, can anyone tell me, we would be discussing about what is software testing and all the things, but before that I want to know what is a software. If you are trying to test something, but before that you should know that what is a software what you are trying to test, right? So what, can anyone tell me what is a software? Hello? Who's this? Can anyone tell me what is a software? Justita, you want to answer?
Oh my God, Monos, hi.
Of course. Are you there?
Yes.
Yes, we are able to hear you. What is the software?
It's a segment of instructions.
Okay, so it is a set of instructions.
Yes, to perform a specific task or some.
Okay, so Tejasvita is saying that it is a set of instructions that you should follow to perform a specific task. That's true. Okay, but can you give me an example of any of the software? What any example of a software? Anyone?
Like reservations, like you can write some instructions to do some reservations, like you can say transport, like bus reservation.
Bus reservations, right? There is a software, suppose yes. There is an online reservation.
Yeah, online reservation.
Okay, that's true.
Then these all the programs, those are softwares.
Yeah, right. Like online banking.
Yeah.
Right? It is a type of a software.
Right.
Your MS Office, that is a type of a software. Emailing. Right. So this is also a software. So anything in which you follow some instructions to perform a duty or to perform a particular task. That is nothing but a software. And today in each and every field, you have a software. In finance, either say in banking, healthcare, spacecraft, in each and every field you have a software. Okay, so from a common person, suppose say like a person who doesn't have any IT background, nothing, okay, but then also he is using a software, suppose say a mobile, that is a software, all the applications in the mobile you are using, so that is nothing but a software. So a common person, from a common person to a IT professional person who is using the computers, okay, so they are using software. So from a common person to the IT professional, each one of us are using some or the other software. Now, before stepping into software testing, this is what a software is. Now, if you want to test something, shouldn't be the thing like you should understand that how it is developed, then only you can test it, right? So before stepping into the software testing, we would go into something like SDLC, that is Software Development Lifecycle. Just a brief introduction about it. What is a Software Development Lifecycle? Okay, but we'll come back to this slide of why we should use that, QA as a career and testing. Okay, so I was telling about Software Development Lifecycle. Forget about software development. Just take a simple thing. Suppose say I want to build my home. Okay, I want a home to be built for me. Now, before building a home, you should have or you must be having some of the other criteria in your mind, right? I want my home to be three bedroom. Okay, I want it either to be two car garage should be there. I want a basement that should either be finished or unfinished. Each one of us have different criteria and different requirements, right? So what we will do, we'll collect all the requirements at one place before building a home. Then, secondly, what we will do, we'll go to the architect, to the concerned person, and we'll tell them all our requirements, correct? Then, depending upon our requirement, the architect would be creating a plan, or you can also say a blueprint. And then he would come up to us and ask us whether the blueprint is proper or not according to our requirements. Correct. Once we have approved the blueprint, then he would ask his construction people to build the home for us. Then once the home is built, what we will do, we will check the home that whether all our requirements are properly there or not. Whether the home is built as per the requirements which we have given to the architect. Correct? Then after that, we'll throw a housewarming party as we all do. And then once we start using the home, then we can fix the smaller problems which were there. Okay, and suppose say like, we have given the requirement that we don't want a finished basement right now, okay. But once we have started using the home, then we wanted, like, now we want a finished basement. So these are the things that we can fix later once we have started using the home. Okay, so these are some of the steps which we go through while building a home. Similarly, while we are constructing or while we are building a software, there are certain steps which are to be followed, which are to be fulfilled. Now, what are these steps? Firstly, the business analyst. I'm using a technical term over here. The business analyst person, he would be gathering all the requirements from the client. Over here, in the example that I have given you for building a home, the person who wants a home to be built, he is the client. So the business analyst person would be taking all his requirements from the client. Then the architect person would be creating the design depending upon the requirements which are given by the client. Okay. Now once the design is completed, then the next phase that comes into the scene is the coding. The programmers, they will do the coding. Then after that, the testers, they come into the scene and they will test that whether they have coded properly or not. And now what is there in the testing? What the testers do? They will check that whether the code or whether the software is working as per the requirements which were given by the client. This is what the testers do. They will check everything in compatibility to the requirements which were given. Then once the things are tested, if they are okay, then it is being released, right? And once the things are released, then the maintenance phase will go on for each and every software. Okay, so why testing is important? From here only you can judge it out. Why testers are important or why testing is important? The reason is if the software is not tested, you cannot release it to the client. It has to be tested. And why testers are important? Because they are the only persons who will give a final go at whether a software should be released or it should not be released. If while testing they feel that the software is not working as per the requirements of the clients, then they could go back to the concerned people and should say that it is not working properly. So again, the designing and the coding has to be done. So a final go has to be given by the testers, and this is why testers are important, and this is why testing is important. Because if the testing is not done properly or if testing is not done at all, then you can't release the product to the client. Is it clear? What is software development lifecycle? Am I clear with the thing? Yes? Anyone has any question regarding this software development lifecycle? Okay. So I feel that this is clear. Software development lifecycle. I will just repeat it one more time. It is a lifecycle that has to be followed to develop a particular software. Now the different phases are the requirement phase, wherein the business analyst will gather all the requirements from the client. Then a design would be done. That is, a design would be done by the senior person depending upon the requirement. Then the coding is done by the programmers. Then after that, the next phase is the testing phase, wherein the testers, they come into use and they will do the testing. And then once the things are tested, once the product is tested, the final go is given, it is being released to the client. If the release is done properly, then the ongoing maintenance is done. Okay? Now, see, for building, these all are the phases in which a software has to be built. Okay, it has to be built. But there are certain methods also in which it can be built. and in the course material will provide you with those things. There are certain methods like say agile method, waterfall methodology, okay, or the scrum methodology. These are some of the methods in which you can build the software. These all are the phases of building a software. Clear with this thing? Okay. Now coming to the main point for which we are here, what is the software testing? Why do we need to test the software? I have given you the answer for that previously only. Why do we need to test the software? But now, before that, what is the software testing? Can anyone tell me? I'm not asking the proper answer for the things, like I'm not asking for proper definition, but just what do you think? What could be software testing? Anyone of you? Yes, Samantha, I have unmuted you.
Testing the software that meets the user requirements.
Yes, testing the software in accordance to the user requirements. Okay, that's it. Okay, in very simple terms, we can say that testing any software or testing anything, if you say in terms of software only, then we can say that testing a software in accordance that whether it is matching up the requirements of the clients or not, right? So this is testing. Now if you talk in terms of software, so you will match up that whether the requirements which are given by the clients for building the software, whether they are completed or not. But do you only have to test about it, that whether all the requirements are met, or do you test something more? Yes, we need to test something more also. And what is that which makes a difference between the programmers and the testers is that, see, you will test that whether the requirements which are given by the clients are fulfilled or not. But at the same time, you also will have to test that your software is not working in which manner it should not work. Okay. Now I'll make it clear with the help of a simple example. Suppose say, let me open a Gmail application for you. I want to create a new account. Now, see, this is the build application, right? But before it was being built, there would be some requirements which were given by the client, right? So the Google must have told his vendor that I want, suppose for the creation of the password. Okay, he must have given the requirement like I want a 7-letter word. It should be accepted. Okay. Okay. To create the Gmail ID, the password, it should be at least 8 characters, right? But what will happen if I'm giving only 7 characters, then what will happen? Should it accept? Ideally, it should not, according to the requirement. Also, you will have to check that if I'm giving the character between 8 to 15, then what should happen? It should get accepted, right? And also you will have to test that what will happen if I give more than 15 characters in this password text box, whether it should get accepted or not. So what was out of the box here was only the requirement which was given is the password should be accepted, all the passwords which are between 8 to 10 or 8 to 15, whatever is the requirement given by the Google. Suppose they, we take it as 8 to 10. If the requirement was given that the password should be between 8 to 10 characters, then as a tester, you will have to test not only that it should accept between 8 to 10, but you also will have to test that it should not accept anything beyond 10 and less than 8. Okay, so this is the thing that makes the difference between the coder and the testers. Because what the coders or what the programmers, they will do, they will just say the requirement like the password text box should accept between 8 to 10 characters. It should accept the characters between 8 to 10. So by coding, they will concentrate only on 8 to 10. That's it. They won't consider the things what will happen if anyone, if any user is giving less than 8 characters, and also if any user is giving more than 10 characters. So this is the loophole that they are creating. So as a tester, if you want to find out a bug and if you want to save your job, then this is the critical point wherein you have to test. Are you getting me, each one of you, what I'm trying to say? Why I said, like, in software testing, you not only will have to test that the software is working as per the requirement, but it should also work, or you should also test the software in extreme conditions. Okay, so as a tester, you have to do all these jobs also. Okay. So what is software testing? It is a process to identify if the software applications are working as per specified in the requirement. As in, when the home was built by the construction people, we will test that whether it is working as per the requirements which we have given to the architect. Okay. Now, suppose say there is the requirement for the Apple.com is for iPhone 6, the resolution, it should be 1334x750, okay, and for iPhone 6 Plus, it should be 1920x1080. So, if you have to test for this resolution as a tester, how would you test it? And also for the size and thickness. For iPhone 6, the size should be, the thickness should be 6.9 mm, and for 6 Plus, it should be 7.1 mm. So, as a tester, you will have to test for these requirements also. So how will you test for that? These are the dimensional and the resolution requirements which are to be tested manually only. Okay. So what do you understand by the word manually? If I say we'll have to test it manually, what do you understand by the word manually? Anyone? Why I use the specific term manually? Anyone? What is manual? Sosna?
Yeah, using it personally to see if how the resolution is like. So unless you use it personally, it is manual.
With your own hands.
With your own hands, yeah.
Exactly. So So if you are using the things with your own hands, if you're seeing with your own eyes, that is manual. And the other word which we use in the software testing, one is manual testing and the other one is the automation testing. We just came across this word, so I'm telling you that one is the manual testing and the other one is the automation testing. What you do in the automation test, there is a tool which will help you to perform the task. And in manual testing, you only will have to use your eyes and your hands to perform a task or to test a software. Else, in automation testing, a tool would be present over there which would do all the things for you. But see, nothing comes like that only. If a tool is present over there to help you out to test the software, then the coding or some type of scripting has to be done before. Okay, so that needs to be done beforehand so that it could help you out in testing the software. We'll discuss about manual and the automation later on. I just came across this word, so I thought I should tell you. Now, this is software testing. Now, as there was a method or there were some phases to create a software, there are some phases to test the software also. Okay, so what are these phases? Just let us understand about that. The first phase is the understanding the requirements. We need to first understand the requirements which are given us by the client. Okay, once you are very much clear of the requirements, you understand what the user wants from you, then only you can go ahead with your testing. Then the second phase that comes into use is the second phase which is there is the designing of the test plan. Now what does this mean? Is test plan means it is a detailed document which needs to be prepared. Okay, then in test plan you need to write down that what all types of testing, there are certain types of testing which we will discuss further, what types of testing should be done, when it should be done, how much testing should be done, and who all are the people who would be involved in that testing. You can't involve each and every tester into a particular testing, right? There are some specialized testers in certain fields. So you have to use both. Then you can't do testing beyond a point because there are certain limitations. Suppose say your timeline has gone or you have to release the software, then you have to stop your testing. Or suppose say your budget is over for the testing, then you will have to stop the testing. So there are certain things which needs to be documented beforehand. So these all documents are done in the, or these all things are taken care in the test plan. Now once the test plan is ready, then you have to design the test cases. Now what you understand by designing the test cases is, again going back to this example of creating the password, okay, so over here the requirement which was given by the Google was the password should be between 8 to 10 characters, right? Then for writing the test case for this particular requirement, for checking this particular requirement would be, firstly you will have to open up this URL. Right. You should open up the page as accounts.google.com. You should have the proper internet connection so that this page is getting loaded. This is the first step that needs to be done. Then the second step would be, you have to write down certain, suppose say I'm writing it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you should write down the password over here, or you should be able to write down anything over here in the password text box. This is your second step which needs to be performed. If you are not able to write down anything in this text box, then you are not able to test this text box. Okay, so this is your second step. So the step-by-step instructions which you give, that all instructions are documented in the form of cases, and those cases are known as the test cases. So that any person or any tester can test the test cases, can test the software looking at the test cases. So So it is a detailed description. Now once the test cases are written, then you have to prepare the test data. Now what is the test data? See, suppose say over here in the create a password textbook, the data which I have given is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Suppose say, let us take some another example. Online banking. If I am checking Bank of America website, okay, and over there I have to give a, I have to check for that whether it is accepting the, whether it is accepting my account number or not. Okay. So while testing this thing in the software industry, do you think that any person would give his original account number and will test with that? Anyone? No. No one would give that, right? So for that, you have to create the test data so that you can test a particular thing. So that test data needs to be prepared. Tejasvita, you have a question? Tejasvita, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. No, I'm good, I said.
Okay, so this is the reason we have to prepare the test data. Suppose say I'm checking online, I'm checking for Amazon. Okay, so once I have selected all the items in my cart box which I want to buy, I have given my cart details, then I'm getting logged out properly. I have to check this thing. So do you think I would give my original credit card details over there? No, no one would give that. So what we need to do, we have to create a dummy data. For creating the software, then that dummy data needs to be prepared, and that is known as the test data. Now once the test data is prepared, then we will execute the test cases. If the execution is done properly, then we would validate the results. Validate the results means we will cross verify that whether what results which we want from the software, it is working or it is matching up or not. If it is matching up means the test case or your software is working properly. If it is not matching up, then it is not working. So these are certain steps which needs to be followed while testing the software. So in short, you can also say it as software testing lifecycle, SPLC, that is T, testing, software testing lifecycle. Now, as a QA, you have to do all these things. You have to understand the requirements properly, then you have to do all the preparations for the test plan, scheduling, budgeting, and checking till what point the testing has to be done, what type of testing has to be done. Then writing down the test cases, preparing the test data, executing the test cases, and then validating the results. Okay, so this is the software testing lifecycle. Is this clear, every one of you? Am I clear with this thing? What is software testing lifecycle and what is the software development lifecycle? Anyone has any question up till this point? Okay, if you have any question, just raise a hand. You can get the option over there to raise a hand, or you can either chat, write your questions in the chat window. I can see a hand of Tejasvita. Okay, Tejasvita, do you have a question?
No, no, it's I don't know, it's a lower hand actually, it's not there.
So I just saw the symbol of raise hand. Okay, no problem. Okay, moving forward. Now, these are the roles of the, what we discussed up till now was the understanding the requirements, preparing all the things and all. Okay, these are some of the important roles of the QA tester. But what, as a tester, what skills do you need? Okay, that is also important. So I would say that the most important skill you should have as a tester are the analytical skills and your passion for doing testing. That will only take you far ahead of other. Okay, if you have the aptitude to break the logic. Now, what do you understand by the aptitude of breaking the logic is you have to think out of the box. This is a common thing that you need to do if you have to be a good tester. Out of the box does not mean that think illogically. It just means think in a way in which a user will be thinking or a user will be using the software. Because you would be getting a ready code, right? So you have to think only from the point of the user. Now think as many possible ways as a user can do. Okay, so in that way you would be able to break the logic. You should have a great, great passion for testing. You should have good documenting skills. Why I'm saying so, you should have good documenting skills is because you have to create a test plan. You have to write down the test cases. So these are all the documentation that needs to be done. Okay. Then you have to prepare the test data. Then you have to validate the results also by executing the test cases. Then, as I told you earlier, that nothing could be achieved. You can't release the software until and unless the testers have given a go, because they only will give a final go to the software. So it is up to you as a tester, if you are doing the software testing properly, if you are checking your software properly, then only a rich quality software will be delivered. Okay, so you are only there to who would be maintaining the quality of the software. So just why the reason you are given the name as QA testers, that is the quality people, because you would be only there to give the highest quality to the software. So make sure you are doing it properly. Then, this is one very important point, that it says like software testing is platform independent and programming language independent. Now, why it is said so? See, we are not aware we are nowhere in building the software. Okay, the coders or the programmers would be building the software. When the programmers are building or when any of the software is being built, either it is built in the Java language or in .NET or SAP or PHP or any other language. Okay? But once it is being built, when it is given to the tester, as a tester, you don't have to worry that in whatever language it is being built. You only will have to check the code. You only will have to check that the software is working properly. In whatever language it is being built, you are nowhere aware of that, and also you won't be emphasized by that. You don't have to worry that in what language it is being built. Suppose say Google is built in .NET. Okay, you are a tester over there. You don't have to go into the, if you are not aware of that technology, that doesn't matter. You only will have to write down the test cases and check that whether it is working properly. And at the other hand, you have some other projects also which is built in PHP. You are a tester, you don't have to worry that whatever language it is being built, you only will have to write down the test cases and check whether it is working properly or not. So as a tester, you don't have to understand the languages, PHP, .NET, Java, you don't have to understand all these things. You only will have to write down the test cases, check whether it is working properly. If not, report it back. If yes, say yes, give a go. That's it. So if there are we say sometimes that Java technology is not that it is in a boom. Okay, if it is in a boom or if it is going down, we don't have to worry because we are not there. We are not over there. Who would be affected by that? So that is why it is said that you have the most safest job, because any of the language which comes and goes by the time. But software testing is a field wherein no languages are required, nothing is required. It's just that you have to test the software in whatever language is required. The coders will come and go depending upon the language which is there in the market. But the tester, they will remain over there because their job doesn't require. And the most important thing is, if you are willing to learn, and if you want to explore the things as a common person, as a common user, then only you could break the aptitude of it. So I would suggest that think in different ways so that you can break the logic of the software, but don't think illogically also. There is a very thin line difference between those two. Now, over here in this curriculum, in Bhartiya Technologies, we would be conducting manual testing. Then after that, we would be having Quality Center. That is a tool which is being used as a test management tool. We would be learning about SQL, Unix. Then for the automation testing, we would be using QTP, which is also known as HP-UFT nowadays. We would also give you some overview of Selenium. You must have heard about this automation testing tool. Then we will be giving you some projects to work upon that so that you can write down the test cases on the live project. You can get your hands-on experience on that. We would help you with your resume preparations so that you can prepare a better resume and can put it into the website. So mock interviews would also be conducted for you. And we would also help you out in marketing the resume for your job placement. We would assist you with that. And also, if sometimes you miss any of the sessions, then we would give you the facility that you could go back to the record. We would record all our sessions and we will provide you with the link. And also all the notes which I am giving in the class, that would also be provided if you are not able to attend the session some or the other day. The problem in that, we would be giving you the recorded link and all, and the notes also. Okay. Now, do you have any questions regarding the things? We have gone through all the things. And we will be starting our batch from tomorrow onwards. So anyone has any questions? Yes, anyone?
Yeah.
Yeah, sir.
Yes, I was thinking, you know, you have mentioned the BA, you know, the work in progress is a BA, and I was wondering if in this particular class that I would be part of for sure from tomorrow onwards, you could always also like emphasize a little bit, because you did say that the requirement aspect of it, you know, that is the way the BA is. So if you could like elaborate a little bit on the BA on the BA skills, like, you know, just how the agile and the scrum thing, and you know, a few of those, if you could add that. Can we request you to add a little bit of the BA also in the class?
Okay, so you want from the BA point of view?
Yes, okay. The requirement, when you're doing the requirements thing, you know, so I wanted you, like, you know, just add a little bit of the BA perspective, because I'm actually a work in progress for the BA. Yeah, I'm you know testing also. I'm just doing this thing to help me and you know to support me, you know, to make me a stronger. But BA is my forte, and I'm already in like the process of a BA. So, you know, since I had absolutely no background about testing, and I'm taking this class, but I would also want to like a little bit aid with the BA. If
okay, sure, no problem. Yes, I would be covering up the session for the agile methodology, the Scrum one and all.
You had mentioned that, so if you could just talk a little bit more as to what would be covering for the BA perspective, I would appreciate it. That was my question, my request, as to what else would you be covering for the BA perspective onwards, because I knew when we came to the requirement analysis, you talked about the BA and you mentioned the Scrum and Agile, so just could you please elaborate that portion of the syllabus?
We are not going through, see, nowadays since only the Agile and the Scrum are used more.
Uh-huh,
so
yes.
What I'll do is, yes, yeah, you are aware of that, I know. So what we'll do is, we'll emphasize more while we are on to the sessions, because if I'll go into the details of that, it would take another 1 or 2 hours of that. Okay, so what we'll do is, we'll emphasize more on your Agile and Scrum methodology. Okay, and apart from that, if you want some more things of BA, then I need to contact the coordinator, okay, and he would come back to you with the things.
Okay.
Will that be fine?
Yeah, that suffices. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Thanks. Anyone else? I just wanted to know that how many of you are from non-IT background? Everyone from IT background?
Not really. My background is in finance, MBA, and you know, but I have had a little bit of experience working with systems like Hyperion. Business objects, and so that so I did go a little bit behind the scenes and like you know the development side, so but I don't have like any education in the IT as such, but yeah, just you know hands-on experience that we've got on the job.
Hello.
Yeah, hi, who is this? George?
Yeah, this is George. But yeah, you know, I also have an MBA background, and I did a little bit of, I suppose,